In this video, we will talk about muscle fatigue. Muscle fatigue refers to the decline in muscle performance, or the inability to maintain force after repeated muscle contractions. It is characterized by a decline in muscle power, endurance, and overall performance. Despite this negative connotation, it serves an important protective role. It signals the body to avoid excessive strain and potential damage, while allowing contractions at reduced rates and lower forces. And of course, as we all have experienced, it's reversible with rest. Now, to understand the mechanisms behind fatigue, first, let's quickly revise some relevant basic points. This is a schematic diagram of muscle with sarcoplasmic reticulum and actin myosin filaments. This is the brain. These are neurons taking signals from the brain to the motor neuron. The motor neuron connects to muscle fiber at the neuromuscular junction. The incoming impulse produces action potential in the postsynaptic membrane. The action potential causes the opening of calcium channels on the membrane as well as on the sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum. The rushing of calcium into cytosol initiates the myosin crossbridge cycle, resulting in muscle contraction. The energy required for this comes from ATPs. For the regeneration of ATPs, glycogen and other resources are used. Blood brings many important nutrients required for all these, especially oxygen. The usage of these sources produces their metabolic end products. To relax the muscle, calcium, and sodium and potassium are pumped back to their original source. So, this was the basic. Understanding the mechanisms of fatigue is easy now. The factors contributing to fatigue can be divided into two broad categories, central and peripheral. Starting from the top, decreased inputs from control centers in the brain and spinal cord and altered excitability of motor neurons decrease muscle activity. Apart from that, emotional factors such as motivation and pain perception also affect brain activity. The fatigue due to these changes in the central nervous system is central fatigue. Its contribution depends on the individual. For example, in highly trained athletes, these factors play a minor role as they have mentally conditioned themselves to discomfort and stress. On the other hand, people who don't do regular exercise experience the effect of these factors relatively sooner. So this was central fatigue. Factors at the level of muscle are included in peripheral fatigue. First, impairment in the initiation or propagation of action potential decreases muscle performance. Second, impaired calcium release and reuptake impairs the muscle's ability to generate force efficiently. Third, and one of the most important factors, the depletion of energy sources such as ATPs, phosphocreatine, and glycogen. Without sufficient energy supply, muscle contractions become weaker, leading to fatigue. Next, the accumulation of metabolic byproducts. For a faster generation of ATPs in the absence of oxygen, the muscle uses the glycolysis pathway. This produces lactic acid and thereby reduces the pH of the muscle cell. This, in turn, inhibits myosin ATPase activity. Crossbridge interaction, binding of calcium to troponin, sodium-potassium ATPase pump, phosphofructokinase, etc. All of these result in decreased muscle contraction. Finally, interruption of blood flow prevents the delivery of important nutrients, especially oxygen. And of course, this also can cause muscle fatigue. So this was peripheral fatigue. Now, a bonus point for those who have seen the video of types of muscle fiber. There we saw that type 1 and type 2A fibers can use oxidative metabolism for energy, so they are more resistant to fatigue. Whereas type 2X/2B fibers mainly use the glycolytic pathway, so they are more prone to fatigue. That's all for muscle fatigue. Now let's have a quick summary. Muscle fatigue is the temporary decline in muscle performance and capacity due to prolonged or intense exertion. It plays a protective role and is reversible on rest. Central fatigue occurs due to decreased inputs to the motor neuron, or alteration in its excitability. Peripheral fatigue occurs due to impairment in the generation, or propagation of action potential, impairment in the release and re-uptake of calcium at the sarcoplasmic reticulum, depletion of energy sources, such as ATPs and glycogen, accumulation of metabolic waste products, such as lactic acid, and impairment in blood supply. That's it for this video. Blah, blah, blah.